Sadist.
Sadist was another band I was so looking forward to at this year's Progpower. I mean, you see that little blip of hair there in the front? Yeah, right there. That's me, going batshit crazy at Sadist. So after enjoying the show, I was very happy to hear that I got the opportunity to interview one of the guys in Sadist. So, here we go.
Hello everybody, we are here with another interview, this time with the guitarist and keyboardist of Sadist. Hi!
Hi guys, hi everybody.
Well, introduce yourself to the audience at home.
I'm Tommy, guitar and keyboard player from Sadist. We're coming from Italy and we play rock and roll.
You play rock and roll, yeah. Okay. Yeah, I think we can, that's pretty broad, but we can work it out later.
Yeah.
If you would have to describe the music of Sadist to a stranger who never heard it before, how would you describe it?
Well, we started 25 years ago, and we were just kids, and we were just playing what we feel like playing. We never planned to do anything special, just wanted to mix all our influences.
Okay.
I was listening a lot to progressive music from the 70s, like Emerson, Lake & Palmer,
this kind
of stuff. Yeah. And some other guys were more into metal, thrash metal, and then we put it together, but we didn't plan anything. It just happened.
Yeah, like it kind of occurred as you did it.
Yes, yes. Right. It was something very natural, actually. Mm-hmm. And little by little, we found out that it was something quite original, and we keep on like that.
Mm-hmm.
And we just tried every time we were recording a new album to do something a little different, to make a step forward in a way. Not just happened, really. Okay. We really had so many different influences. I mean, when I was a kid, I was so much into... I'm a guitar player, so when I was 15, I was every day playing the Yngwie Malmsteen, trying to be like Yngwie Malmsteen, because at the time it was normal. Yes, it was normal. And the drummer, that is not this actual drummer, it was another one, was more into death metal.
All right.
And the bass player also, Andy, was into something else. And we just mixed it together. Yep. We had some classical stuff because of the keyboards, because of the Malmsteen and classical music influences. So we were more into classical influences mixing with death metal.
And that's your background?
Yes,
as a
because
composer and as a player.
I studied classical guitar when I was a kid in the beginning. We were playing something like, we can call it symphonic death metal.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Yeah, yeah.
And then in a while we started to put influences from tribal music, from ethnic and world music. And when we made the second album, and some people were shocked.
If you would have to look at your career with Sadist, right? Is there a specific moment or thing that happened which you would consider to be, well, your finest achievement so far? I mean, that can obviously change in the future. But if you have to point out one thing now, which would that be?
Sadist was something like it would never been just a primary job. I mean, we never realized to make it as a full-time job because it would be impossible for us.
It's hard, it's
you
hard
have
to make
this
type
of
music. Yeah, exactly.
And every time you have to find compromises, but sometimes you find the right moment when you're doing something very good and you know that you're doing something very good. For instance, a very important moment for us was in 2007. We stopped in 2000 for some years because after the fourth album, it was very bad album and nobody liked it.
Yeah.
And we decided to quit for a while. At the time, it was like we wanted to quit forever.
Yeah.
Then after 4 or 5 years, we say,
You did get the itches.
Yes.
Like we wanted to get back on stage again. Yeah,
and the first time we came back on the stage, it was 2006, something like this. It was a big festival in Italy. And the audience was completely crazy for us because we found out that there were so many people that loved the band. And
but you just never heard it when you were doing
it.
For the final question, because this was your first time at Progpower, right?
Yes.
First time playing here. The ending question is always the same, but that is, what do you think of the whole Progpower vibe and playing here? And what has it been like for you guys? How does it feel?
I love it because the band that we just heard, it was so interesting, so different from the average band you can see in a hard rock or heavy metal festival.
Yeah, exactly.
And when you go to such a festival, when you really see something different, and few hours before you had a death metal band like Sadist playing, and now you have this kind of I don't know, different kind of art. And
just for the record, that's Nordic Giants. They just wrapped up their
Nordic
set.
Nordic Giants.
Yeah, so that's what we're talking about right here.
And that's really interesting. That's art for me, where everything is mixing. Yeah. And something funny about Sadist, you know, we are usually people think about Sadist like a death metal band, but we are not so extreme. So what happens when we are in death metal festival, we always are the
softest band.
The softest
band.
Yeah. And today was funny because we were the most extreme. That was funny for us.
It's also a thing, I think, with a regular metal festival, they would be expecting, it's going to be a death metal band. So it would be like, tuck, 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 tuck. You know,
it's
like
not
that.
Interesting.
No, exactly.
It's not interesting.
So, it is interesting to the death metal fans,
yeah,
but you're
probably
not that type of band.
No, that's the problem with Sadist. Nobody knows which kind of band Sadist is.
Well,
that's the problem.
Wouldn't that make you a progressive band then?
Maybe. Who knows?
I think we have a conclusion, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, yes, he thinks so too. There we go. Well, I just wanted to say, once again, as a fan and, also as a music lover here, thank you for a great show.
Thank you for the interview.
And hope you will have a safe trip home.
Thank you very much.
All right. And we're done.
what can I say as a final verdict? Sadist was one of those bands that divided the audience. One half totally hated it, which is mostly the half that comes here for melodic prog metal bands. Let's face it, Sadist is really loud. It is a death metal band in origin. But it's not like there's a lot of death metal bands out there who have a guitar player that plays keyboards as well, or a bass player that plays the bass that way, or a drummer that plays the drums that way, or a singer that screams and grunts the way he does. Basically, Sadist is unique and authentic, and that's why I love them.